Hey, you know when people book a meeting in Calendly and then you do the back and forth, how did you want to meet? And you think, oh, we're going to meet over Zoom. Great, can you send me the link? So then you've got to go into Zoom, you've got to go and create a meeting, and then you copy and paste the invitation and send it off to them. There's a lot of back and forth, and that can take a lot of time. But imagine if you could just get them to book the meeting in Calendly, and automatically it creates a meeting in Zoom so that once you actually go in to open the meeting when it's time, it's already got the link to your Zoom call. I'm going to show you how to do that right now. You need to have Calendly for booking to allow people to book appointments and Zoom. So I have my Zoom account, but actually where I'm going to make the changes in Calendly. So I'm going to log on to Calendly. And what I'm looking to do is what we call integrations. So that's how Calendly connects to other things such as Zoom. So go to integrations here. And then you get to pick which ones you want. The one I want is Zoom down here. Click on that. And it says, great, connect Zoom. So I need a Zoom account, which I've got, a premium Calendly subscription. So that means that you are actually a paying Calendly subscriber, not one of the free ones. And if you are the Zoom account administrator, if you're not, then whoever the administrator is needs to give this approval. But I'm going to assume that you are the administrator. So let's just click connect Zoom. So here's where I'm logging into Zoom and saying, well, okay, this is what it's going to do. View and manage my current users' meetings, view my meetings, and check my profile. And I'll say, yeah, that's all cool. I'm going to hit authorize. Now, one little trick here. So this is saying add the location. So remember on a Calendly event, or on a calendar event, you get this location. Like, where is it? Well, that's if it's a real live event. Of course, this is an event in online. Okay, so we just say, okay, well, so we've already connected now. Now, what we have to do is go into the different types of events I've got, and then for location, select Zoom. I'm going to show you how to do that now. Go to event types. I have three kinds of event types in my business. So one is a one-on-one call here, one is the introductory call, a different thing, and the other one is a 90-minute coaching session. So let me just go into here. I'll just show you how to do this for one of them, one event type, and I'm going to click on here and I'm going to go edit. And you can see all of these things in here. I'm going to say, what event is this? It's a call with Anthony. And that location, I'm going to say it's Zoom. Now, I'm going to show you one little hint here. I have actually included the instructions in here in the description because in Google Calendar, if you click Zoom, it's going to do a Google Map search for a place called where Zoom's head office is. I mean, really, come on. So I like to put this description in too. This is just a bit of a welcome message when people book a call. I can pick a color for my event and I'm going to click save. And that's it. And now I'm going to pretend that I am a client of mine or a prospect who wants to book that event. So let's view the live page. And I'm going to book a time. And in fact, it's already got these instructions here. So I'm going to book a time. I'll just connect it here, confirm. And then once I put that in, then whoever the person is connecting to book that call gets a message saying, here's how to connect. So then when you come in to when it's time for your meeting, you just open the Zoom session, you start the Zoom session, and then you're in business. Okay, now let me just jump across to Zoom, and then what I'll see is those meetings, or actually I haven't booked that meeting yet, let me book that meeting now. So I'm going to book the meeting, and I'm going to say, I'm going to go say my name is Fred Smith, and I'm going to give a dummy address, or actually I've got to give a real address, there we go, and I'll go schedule event. So that event is booked, and now on that calendar invitation, I'm going to get a message saying connect. I, as the client, am going to get a message saying connect to the when the time comes, when the calendar event comes, connect via Zoom. And that's it. I'm already set up then. And so that way I can receive, I can send it. I don't have to go and set up all of that Zoom stuff myself after people book the meeting. Isn't that good?